And now, the news from our London studios. MTA International brings you the world news.
Assalamu alaikum and welcome to MTA News. Today, the promised Messiah, peace be upon him's newspaper, Al-Hakam, published a new exclusive interview with Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmed, may Allah be his helper. And later in this program, MTA News will inshallah ask Al-Hakam editor Qasid Mu'in Sahib to share some of the behind-the-scenes stories that are related to this very special interview of beloved Huzur, may Allah be his helper. But we start today's program with some highlights from earlier this week when Hazrat Khalifatul Masih, may Allah be his helper, met with the UK Khudam National Amla.
Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmed, may Allah be his helper, graciously granted the National Amla of the Ahmadiyya Muslim Youth Association, UK, a 40-minute audience on Saturday. His Holiness repeatedly emphasized the importance of the five daily prayers and of offering them in congregation.
The basic thing is prayers. If they are not offering five-time daily prayers, then there's no use of having any other meeting or any engagement or anything else. And those who are already offering five-time daily prayers, then they should take one step ahead, that is to involve themselves in offering congregational prayer, at least three congregational prayers.
Hazur also mentioned how a group of 20 Atfal aged 7 to 15 from East Midlands had travelled for several hours overnight solely to offer Fajr prayer behind him at the London Mosque that very morning. In fact, the visit was part of a campaign that has seen Atfal from 9 regions visit the London Mosque for Fajr prayer behind Hazur in recent weeks. Later in the meeting, Hazur lovingly drew the attention of the Amla towards the efforts they needed to make in the months ahead. The meeting ended with a question on how office bearers could become true role models for the youth.
Five-time daily prayer in congregation. Your good morals. Your a way of, you know, talking with each other. Code of dress. Your modesty. So your personal character. This is how you can attract your khudam. If you are not offering five-time daily prayer, how can you ask them to do... to come to the mosque. If your way you are treating others is not good, how can you ask them to adopt good morals? Set your own examples. If Qayadeens are particular in this regard and they change themselves and make them the role model, you will see there's a big and significant change among Khudam as well.
Those were just some select highlights from one of Huzur's many, many engagements, office meetings and personal meetings over the past week. We're now joined in the news studio by Qasid Mu'in Sahib, the editor of Al-Hakam newspaper, which today just published a new exclusive interview with Hazrat Khalifatul Masih, may Allah be his helper. Qasid Sahib, thank you for joining us. When did this interview take place and how did it come about?
So this interview took place over a series of mulaqats with Hazur, and one of our the members of Al-Hakam, Asif Basitsab, he had the honour. He would ask a question, and depending on how much time Hazur had, Hazur would share some account. Hazur shared with us something which I believe that the Jamaat has never before seen, and that's some of the notes that he takes on a weekly basis of his Friday sermons and his speeches. So Hazur has a notepad, a notebook. What happened was that Asif Basitsab saw one of those notebooks, and Hazur saw the curiosity in Asif Sab's eyes, and Hazur said, have a look at this. And so later on, when Asif Sab sought permission to include one of those pages in Al-Hakam, Hazur also approved that, and that is being included in Al-Hakam this week. There are two pages. One is from the inauguration of a Jalsa Salana Qadian, and one is the concluding address of a Jalsa Salana Qadian. And on top of every single page, you see the words written, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Allahumma ayyidni biruhil Qudus. That literally means, in the name of Allah, the gracious, the merciful, and O Allah, help me with the spirit of truth.
And does Hazrat Khalifatul Masih, may Allah be his helper, keep a close watch on the writings and the publishings of Al-Hakam?
I remember when Hazur came back from the United States, from his recent tour, what we thought was when Hazur returns, we would submit those hard copies of Al-Hakam. When we gave those issues, I was honestly very surprised to learn that Hazur's first response was that although I read them when I was in the USA, as and when they would be published, but okay, you can put them there on the table. So that was very surprising for me, that Hazur, in that busy time, in that busy period, he would actually take the time out to read Al-Hakam. One of the interesting things is that such interviews, Hazur, obviously in the limited period of time that Hazur has, he shares with us the information that comes to light. And then afterwards, upon reflection, when Hazur goes back and reads that interview, because Hazur is a regular reader of Al-Hakam, Hazur reads those interviews as well, and then sometimes that jogs his memory to remember other instances. The statistics that we can see on our website and our app, you know, in times when we publish such interviews or such special memories of Hazur, which he has shared with us out of his precious time, the figures just spike, you know, the figures are soaring in those moments. Everyone's visiting the website and the app in those very moments, and they're downloading the PDF to share with their friends and family.
Qasid Mu'in Sahib, thank you for joining us. We end each week with our summary of the Friday sermon.
Hazrat Mirza Masroor Ahmed Mehlabia's helper today continued his series of sermons on the companions of the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. During this series, Hazur has delivered scholarly analyses of various historical incidents, quoting many texts, including the works of Hazrat Muslim Aud radiallahu anhu and Hazrat Mirza Bashir Ahmed radiallahu anhu. This time he focused on various incidents from the Battle of Uhud. Unfortunately, on this occasion, some of the Muslims failed to obey an instruction of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As a result, from a winning position, the Muslims instead endured a dangerous and costly attack from the aggressive Meccan army. Quoting extensively from the writings of Hazrat Muslim Aud, today's sermon recounted the painful situation which emerged towards the end of the battle.
فرماتے ہیں کہ وہ صحابہ جو رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے گرد تھے اور جو کفار کے ریلے کی وجہ سے پیچھے دھکیل دیے گئے تھے, کفار کے پیچھے ہٹتے ہی وہ پھر رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کے گرد جمع ہو گئے اور آپ کے جسم مبارک کو انہوں نے اٹھایا اور ایک صحابی عبیدہ بن الجراح نے اپنے دانتوں سے آپ کے سر میں گھسی ہوئی کیل کو زور سے نکالا جس سے ان کے دو دانت ٹوٹ گئے. تھوڑی دیر بعد رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کو ہوش آ گیا. جب دامنِ کوہ میں بچا کچا لشکر کھڑا تھا تو ابو سفیان نے بڑے زور سے آواز دی اور کہا, ہم نے محمد کو مار دیا. رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے ابو سفیان کی بات کا جواب نہ دیا تا ایسا نہ ہو کہ دشمن حقیقت حال سے واقف ہو کر حملہ کر دے, پھر کیونکہ مسلمان ابھی کمزور حالت میں تھے اور زخمی مسلمان پھر دوبارہ دشمن کے حملے کا شکار ہو جائیں. جب اسلامی لشکر سے اس بات کا کوئی جواب نہ ملا تو ابو سفیان کو یقین ہو گیا کہ اس کا خیال درست ہے اور اس نے بڑے زور سے آواز دے کر کہا, ہم نے ابو بکر کو بھی مار دیا. رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے ابو بکر کو بھی حکم فرمایا کہ کوئی جواب نہ دیں. پھر ابو سفیان نے آواز دی, ہم نے عمر کو بھی مار دیا. تب عمر جو بہت جوشیلے تھے, انہوں نے اس کے جواب میں یہ کہنا چاہا کہ ہم لوگ خدا کے فضل سے زندہ ہیں اور تمہارے مقابلے کے لیے تیار ہیں, مگر رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے منع فرمایا کہ مسلمانوں کو تکلیف میں مت ڈالو اور خاموش رہو. اب کفار کو یقین ہو گیا کہ اسلام کے بانی کو بھی اور اس کے دائیں بائیں بازو کو بھی ہم نے مار دیا. اس پر ابو سفیان اور اس کے ساتھیوں نے خوشی سے نعرہ لگایا, یا اول حبل, کہ ہمارے معزز بت حبل کی شان بلند ہو کہ اس نے آج اسلام کا خاتمہ کر دیا ہے. وہی رسول کریم, مسلموں فرماتے ہیں کہ وہی رسول کریم صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم جو اپنی موت کے اعلان پر, ابو بکر کی موت کے اعلان پر اور عمر کی موت کے اعلان پر خاموشی کی نصیحت فرما رہے تھے تا ایسا نہ ہو کہ زخمی مسلمانوں پر پھر کفار کا لشکر لوٹ کر حملہ کر دے اور مٹھی بھر مسلمان ان کے ہاتھوں شہید ہو جائیں. لیکن اب جب کہ خدا واحد کی عزت کا سوال پیدا ہوا اور شرک کا نعرہ میدان میں مارا گیا تو آپ کی روح بیتاب ہو گئی اور آپ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے نہایت جوش سے صحابہ کو دیکھ کر فرمایا کہ تم لوگ جواب کیوں نہیں دیتے. صحابہ نے کہا, یا رسول اللہ, ہم کیا کہیں؟ فرمایا کہ کہو, اللہ اعلی واجل, اللہ اعلی واجل, تم جھوٹ بولتے ہو, حبل کی شان بلند ہوئی ہے
اللہ وحدہ لا شریک ہی معزز ہے اور اس کی شان ہی بالا ہے. اور اس طرح آپ نے اپنے زندہ ہونے کی خبر دشمنوں تک پہنچا دی. اس فرماتے ہیں کہ اس دلیرانہ اور بہادرانہ جو آپ کا اثر کفار کے لشکر پر اتنا گہرا پڑا کہ باوجود اس کے کہ ان کی امیدیں اس جواب سے خاک میں مل گئیں اور باوجود اس کے کہ ان کے سامنے مٹھی بھر زخمی مسلمان کھڑے ہوئے تھے جن پر حملہ کر کے ان کو مار دینا مادی قوانین کے لحاظ سے بالکل ممکن تھا, وہ دوبارہ حملہ کرنے کی ضرورت نہیں کر سکے, لیکن اس نعرے کو سن کے, یہ جوش دیکھ کر.
At the end of the sermon, Hazur announced he would lead the funeral in absentia of Nadir al-Husni Sahib of Canada and paid lengthy tribute to a life which was filled with good deeds and devotion to Khilafat-e-Ahmadiyya.